Warren Barker. I asked Warren a month ago if he would introduce me, because I just can't imagine anybody speaking after him. Thank you, Warren. I also want to thank Terry Lanza for her acknowledgement of John McCrae. That was very kind of you and very appropriate. And we should all not forget John's role at IYRS. And some of you may not know that the board has decided to name a mill building after John. And so there'll be a ceremony. One is Jenny Holmquist, who's our events manager, and Jenny does this event, the gala, graduation. Jenny, where are you? Thank you, Jenny. There are a couple of past chairmen in the room, and I want to acknowledge David Pedrick, who in 2004. Isdale is in the room as well. And I want to thank our sponsors again, particularly Hunt and Betsy Lawrence for being a sponsor of this evening, and a call out to Don Riley at Oak Cliff, because they I wish I had half of her energy. And State Street, I think the Fearless Girl is just awesome, and the timing of it is just, just so spot on. So thank you for that, and thank you for being so generous to IYRS. And finally, I want to thank my wife, Marilyn Cantor, who has given up thriving psychotherapy practices twice for me, once in New York and once again in Connecticut. And so that's pretty remarkable. It's not really very difficult to live with a psychotherapist. I can't imagine what it's like to live with me. So I want to talk this evening about two things. One, what's called the adjacent possible, and the other, appropriately, about Elizabeth Meyer. I want to share with you this evening that it's not my idea, but the adjacent possible is something that I think really has. It applies to the journey to many of its students and to what I believe can continue to be a very significant narrative for the school. I'm going to begin with Elizabeth and Elizabeth's great accomplishment. In my view, it was not in just restoring Endeavor, which I can't imagine any one person having done, or being a big factor in preserving the craft associated with the Yacht restoration, but envisioning a unique learning environment that is also an intersection, arguably, of some of the greatest yachts, Newport's history, and our need to connect with something inherently part of our being, which is our past. There's a fellow named Stephen Johnson, who I learned first about through Richard Saul Werman's book, Understanding, Understanding. And he's the author of books about innovation and the history of knowledge. And he's written, if we want to understand where good ideas come from, we have to put them in context. I'm going to kind of offer a lofty analog to IYRS is perhaps a stretch, but I think it makes some sense. Darwin's world-changing idea unfolded inside his brain, but think of all the experiences and tools he needed to piece them together. A vessel, by coincidence, an archipelago, a notebook, a library, a coral reef. Our thoughts, according to Johnson, shape the space that we inhabit, what a space Elizabeth must have inhabited as she took on Endeavor as a challenge. She shared with me once that the project was so exhausting that it put her in the hospital for over a week. I guess, in a small way, I'm comparing IYRS's genesis to Darwin's theory of evolution, but I think Johnson is onto something with universal application. I'm pretty sure that Elizabeth and John's ideas about starting a school came from after a succession of events and a lot of thinking. While the talk of educators at the time was, let's round up every warm body and send them to college and then to a cubicle, Elizabeth was sailing, and as a young adult, restoring historic homes on Martha's Vineyard. But consider her IYRS moment, if there was such one. The trajectory of her passion for making stuff, building, and restoring at a time when shop classes were being dismantled wholesale in the schools. Her love of sailing and its history, then a vision for a place, a unique learning experience, a tract of harborfront property with historic buildings in an iconic community known for both boats and buildings. Could it be more perfect? And still, more iconic yachts for Elizabeth. Another J-class yacht, Shamrock, and of course, Coronet, the 133-foot schooner yacht owned by Arthur Curtis James, who built railroads across America and sailed the seas. It's pretty compelling and pretty big thinking on her part. Elizabeth's idea unfolded inside her brain and then evolved, changing the trajectory now for nearly 800 graduates, spanning a broad range of outcomes both in and outside the marine trades. Phil Irwin, who was graduate number one, is still very much in touch with the school and now runs the San Francisco Bay Maritime Organization. Carter Richardson and Seth Hagen, both of whom are here this evening, founded one of the premier restoration and boat building companies in New England. Jens Lang, also here this evening, founded one as well, equally noteworthy. Dustin Brout is a head designer for a major SpaceX subcontractor in the San Francisco Bay Area. Others are engineers on mega yachts, commercial tugboat crew, marine mechanics, industrial designers, composites technicians, museum curators, entrepreneurs, and on and on and on. And there are others here tonight who fall into those categories. To these grads, the world is not abstract because their hands and minds work together. The tools Elizabeth and ultimately IYRS needed to evolve have been the collection and sequence of all these events. It's the adjacent possible, as the scientist Stuart Kaufman calls that. It is what created and has expanded IYRS and clarified the school's core operating system, or its DNA. We build and we restore things. Overlay on the process some structure and repetition, create some time to explore, make a few mistakes, test the boundaries of materials, solve some problems, learn new tools, and work with people like Warren Barker. As Warren describes it, realize the magic in our fingertips. IYRS is no longer a single program or material, but a learning model. Each new program, the adjacency of programs, the sum of students and campus experiences have opened up both opportunity for IYRS and its students for a broader relevancy. There's plenty of room and demand for taking IYRS beyond where it is today. I would argue its continued relevancy is dependent on its continued evolution in the current landscape of accelerating change in education and in the job market. At the time Elizabeth and John envisioned IYRS, the idea was absolutely right, but the world wasn't ready then for the IYRS of today. The world now needs IYRS, both the school's outcomes and the school's values. IYRS has inhabited a unique opportunity and now has the capacity and physical plant, curricula, and learning model to be part of and a voice for changing education, the kind that some educators say will be essential for America to be competitive in the 21st century. Who would have thought in 2005, when this current evolution began, that boats would be a great metaphor for building almost anything? We did at IYRS. Elizabeth and John did. People in this room, like David Pedrick and Dewey and Jerry Migliaccio and Ed Kane and Deborah Hadley and Seth Hagen and others, I believe, thought that. Although Ed said to me once, he didn't actually agree, but he would support it because it's rational. Over the past 10 years, IYRS has invested nearly $2 million in curricula alone and over $14 million in facilities and an environment that is integral to the IYRS experience for its students. Perhaps as many as 40% of high school graduates today could excel in an IYRS experience. Many would move on to rewarding careers. And to use Matthew Crawford's words, someone that I think some of you here have read his book, Shop Class and Soul Craft, these kind of experiences allow one to use a field of action where you can put your best capacities to work and actually see the effect in the world. I will be leaving IYRS at a time of wonderful adjacent possibilities, but also with plenty of work for IYRS to do. We now need to focus on filling that capacity, as well as being flexible in our delivery. If we agree that many world-changing ideas unfold through the kind of innovation that is evolutionary, even if it's in rapid succession, then IYRS is not done. It too can disappear, like other schools are disappearing today. To realize what is truly possible, I hope next leadership resists ossified traditions of institutionalization and embraces the kind of junkyard and garage creativity that spawned IYRS and other educational institutions like Singularity University, Khan Academy, and other game changers in learning. Importantly, understanding how the market is radically altering delivery for IYRS in scheduling term and through partnerships, private labeling for employers, and next generation learning tools like virtual reality will be an important part of the school's strategic thinking. We can adapt and remain committed to our learning model and our core experience, which is critical and is relevant. And I know that IYRS's board knows this, and that we should not forget that we build stuff at IYRS. Only now, with a bigger toolbox, agnostic about the material or the tool or technology that is in that toolbox. So I'll end with the following. One of my favorite living artists, David Sally, wrote a book recently called How to See. And in it, he refers to the multiplier effect of good art, including its effect on the artist. When you look at a really good painting, or a finely made chair, or a fine automobile, or one of those wonderful Columbia Herschoff dinghies, in all their respective forms and beauty, you see more than what is there in splendidly transformative work. It's unlocked every term in the IYRS experience for people. Many of our students who incrementally gain insight and confidence as they move through the process of making something, ultimately, they gain a self-permission to succeed. It is catalytic, and it is amazing to see. And it's not surprising when you're around people like Warren and other instructors who really facilitate an environment of exploration and not being afraid of making mistakes and continuing to learn and push and work together to learn more. Crawford says that our work either forms us or deforms us. And I've seen the IYRS experience transform lives, laying out a platform for a career and a life. I hope IYRS stays hungry, really hungry, and I hope all of you here tonight help IYRS live up to its own mantra of make anything possible. I plan to continue supporting IYRS, and I wouldn't be doing my job if I didn't say I hope you all will do the same, because this school is on a very interesting and almost unique trajectory, and we need to see where it can go, and there's a lot of upside. So I want to thank all of you tonight, and I appreciate you all coming and all of your support. Thank you.